You're watching Sligo Today. I'm Emily Jennings, and we're at the Temple House Festival with Adam from the Barney Mob. How are you?
Good, I'm very good.
You were just off the stage after an electric performance. Everybody was going crazy.
They seemed to like it, yeah. They seemed to like it. It was good. You have to say, it was probably one of the best gigs that we've done so far. Just energy-wise off the crowd and all, it was amazing. To look back and see everybody there, you know, so.
Well, you clearly loved it as well, yeah, I think, which is a big help.
I had an absolute ball, and I loved every second of it. I'm still coming down off the adrenaline, I think, you know, a little bit. But it was good.
You're only together a year now, but you're playing a lot of festivals and you won an award very recently in the Rising Stars. Tell us about that.
Yeah, that's right. We've been together since April of 2010. So what are we now, June 2011? So yeah, just over a year. And yeah, when we started the band, basically like 3-4 weeks later, we entered a competition called the Rising Stars Dublin City Soul Festival. And we played with a lot of other bands, and there was people, judges in the crowd and whatever. So a couple of weeks later, we said, okay, the Barney Mob won the Rising Stars, and we were going, that's amazing, like, you know, really, really humble, like, this is amazing that we won this, you know. So we got rehearsal space and we got recording time, and it was good. We got the headline, the Soul Picnic then, like 2 weeks ago in Merrion Square, like there's probably a couple of thousand people there, like, so it was good. I know Chris Maher, like the guy who runs it, is a gent, and he's put the festival on 5 years in a row. For, you know, virtually no funding or any of these things. He's just doing it for the people, you know, and that's kind of what the Barley Mob is doing, or trying to do as well. So it was an instant connection with the man, you know, happy to work with him, you know, it was good.
Really. You played with Jack L for a while as well, so how did the Barley Mob come about? Whose idea was it?
The Barley Mob came about, I worked with Jack L for a good 4 years, and I got to play some fantastic places in Glastonbury and all the finest venues the country has, and that was a good experience. And then I'd finished up, and I'd say maybe 4 or 5 months passed, and I was writing a lot of songs, and then the style of what I was writing changed to a little bit more of a sort of social conscience about what it was. So I said, right, I'm going to put a band together. So I got Neil Butler, I'll tell you the story about him. I basically put a thing online and I said, I'm looking for a drummer, you know. And I got maybe 10 people replied. And at the time, I was listening to a band called the John Butler Trio from Australia. Very, very good band, have you heard of them? Looked him up, they're good, right? And because his name was Neil Butler, I just picked his name out of the list because I was like, hang on, Butler, John Butler, right, okay. And everything that's happened for the band so far has been like that. Like, we played around at the start as a three piece. There was myself, Andy on guitar, and Neil on drums, and John, our bass player now, he was in at a gig that we played as a three piece, and he was there promoting the studio he works for. And he came up and he was talking to us. Actually, no, sorry, we played on a Thursday, he was there. And the Friday we played a gig out on Captain America's. And he travelled from Kildare to Captain America's to talk to us and give us flyers, you know. And during the conversation, he said he played bass, and we needed a bass player. And I was like, do you want to play bass, like? And it turned out he's one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet. Like, he's perfect for the job, like.
So seven of you in the band.
Seven of us now, yeah. It's only a recent addition of bringing brass in, which I think ties everything together. Barry Kett, he's a fantastic player, you know. And he plays the whistles as well, which is good for the Irish side of what we're doing. So, yeah, and the keyboard, Conor Bourne, he's been with us now about 4 or 5 months, and he's doing really well. He's starting to really come out of his shell every gig, you know. It's been good. It's been really, really just enjoyable, more so than anything else, you know.
And you're a reggae band, and you really bring that into the audience as well. You can see everyone just chilled out, yeah, and bouncing around.
It's good. I think it's a nice style to kind of play with, because it gives you the opportunity to get messages across and try and connect with people on a one-to-one level, as opposed to, there's a lot of bands go out and there's the ego and the shades and you know, and that's fine as well, because music is about that as well, you know.
So festival highlights?
Festival highlights, tonight probably, it's up there. I think, I don't know, there's been several moments in there. I said to the lads, I felt like I was looking at the band out in the crowd, looking in, like a couple of moments of trying to get my head together, you know. It was good. Probably something to do with the fact that I haven't slept in 2 days, but it might have something to do, you know. But yeah, it's been good. We've been really busy with festivals, and we'll keep going as you know, as long as we can, you know.
Yeah, and you're going to be back in Sligo again soon.
Yeah, we're back at No Place Like Down on the 19th, next Sunday. So that should be good. We're in Body and Soul on the 18th. And yeah, we've loads going on. So we have a Facebook page and all that crack, so, you know. Yeah, if you want to look up the Barley Mob on Facebook, check us out on YouTube and all those places. So
brilliant. Appreciate it. Thanks very much, and enjoy the rest of it, and we'll talk to you again soon.
Cheers, appreciate it.